Well, the ranch started in about 1955. We bought it as a purebred operation because it was right along the interstate, and we built it up to where it looks pretty nice, so it's attractive. You know, first impression is something that people never forget. It keeps getting a little bit bigger like everybody else, because you have to keep them getting more to, but my two sons are basically managing it and overseeing it. And so far they're doing real well. And if they have any questions, they ask me, and I try to tell them the best I can. And most of it they listen to. And so experience is still the best teacher. My family immigrated from Holland here in the early 1900s or late 1800s. I don't remember which one it was for sure, but it was some way in that time period. And they were hardworking and fussy. You didn't sit around the table drinking coffee. You went to work and you worked hard. And so I got taught pretty good when I was younger. And, you know, my dad always said, "It'll never go behind going ahead." So you think about that once, and as long as you can move ahead a little bit, you'll always be there. My dad was a tight old Dutchman, so I had to be that way too, didn't I? That's the kind of the way it goes. Genetics is genetics. It works in people the same way as it does in cattle. I started out with a few commercial cattle, and I had a few of another breed, and the Angus just outdid everything else. I hope my boys can keep it going and expand on what I've done, and I think they will. It appears they are anyway. I've got some pretty good kids, and they do all right. You want me to get you a picture of a perfect Angus cow?
Sure.
Okay, you hang on just a minute, and I'll go do that.